This is the story of Alice in Wonderland. You can read along with me in your book. You will know it is time to turn the page when you hear the chimes ring like this. Let's begin now. Do you know where Wonderland is? It's the place you visit in your dreams. That strange and wondrous land where nothing is as it seems. Alice learned all about Wonderland one warm golden afternoon when she fell asleep under a cool, shady tree. The first strange thing that Alice saw in Wonderland was a white rabbit wearing pants and a waistcoat. He rushed down the path, glancing hurriedly at his watch.
I'm late. I'm late for a very important date. No time to say hello, goodbye. I'm late, I'm late, I'm late, I'm late.
Alice watched him scurry across a brook and disappear into a hollow tree.
Now this is curious. What could a rabbit possibly be late for? It must be a party or something.
Alice crossed the brook and peered into the hollow tree.
What a peculiar place to have a party.
She squeezed through the opening and found herself crawling down a dark tunnel.
I really shouldn't do this. After all, I haven't been invited. And curiosity often leads to trouble.
The tunnel floor abruptly ended, and Alice fell down a large hole. But it wasn't a dirty, musty hole. It was like a tall, thin house. There were bookshelves and cupboards and pictures on the wall. And Alice was falling very slowly, so she had time to look around and think.
What if I should fall right through the center of the earth and come out the other side?
Alice landed with a bump, just in time to see the white rabbit disappear through a tiny door.
Mr. Rabbit, wait, please.
Alice squeezed through the door and found herself outside again.
Oh, dear. I'm sure the white rabbit came this way.
But when Alice looked around, she found everything either upside down or backwards.
Curiouser and curiouser,
thought Alice. Stranger still, whenever Alice would eat a bit of cake, or take a sip to drink, she would change sizes. Once, a bite of mushroom sent her shooting up in height. Her head cleared the treetops and frightened the birds nesting there. Another bite made Alice shrink so small that the flowers and the rocking horsefly towered above her. Alice also met talking animals in Wonderland. There was the walrus, and the dodo, and the caterpillar. They tried to help Alice with her search for the white rabbit, but they mainly took up her time with funny songs and silly races.
Forward, backward, inward, outward, bottom to the top. Makes the difference where you run as long as you don't stop.
So Alice went off to find the white rabbit by herself. Alice came to a clearing, and there stood a small house with pink shutters and a round door.
Now I wonder who lives here,
thought Alice. Just then, the front door flew open and out raced the white rabbit.
Oh me, oh my, I'm awfully late. My fuzzy ears and whiskers took me too much time to shave.
The white rabbit looked up to see Alice at the garden gate.
Why, Mary Ann, what are you doing here? Well, don't just do something, stand there. No, 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 go get my gloves. I'm late.
But late for what?
Asked Alice.
My gloves,
said the white rabbit firmly. So Alice dutifully went to look for them, though she knew full well that she wasn't Mary Ann. When Alice came back, the white rabbit was just disappearing through the woods again.
You see, I'm overdue. I'm in a rabbit stew. Can't even say goodbye. Hello, I'm late, I'm late, I'm late.
Alice rushed off into the woods again. Only this time, she was greeted by a funny pair of twins named Tweedledum and Tweedledee.
Say how do you do, and shake hands, state your name and business.
When Alice said her business was finding the White Rabbit, the two sillies directed her to the Mad Hatter's tea party.
Sit down and join us, my dear,
said the Mad Hatter.
Since it's not our birthdays today, the March Hare and I decided to celebrate our un-birthdays.
Why, then it's my un-birthday today, too,
exclaimed Alice. And they all celebrated with tea and cake.
A very merry un-birthday to you. A very merry birthday to you, to you. It's great to drink to someone, and I guess that you will do. A very merry birthday to you.
Statistics prove that you one birthday every year.
But there are 364 un-birthdays. That is why we're gathered here to cheer. A very merry unbirthday to us, a very merry unbirthday to us, if there are no objections, let it be unanimous, a very merry unbirthday to us.
Left the party and next came to a lovely garden where playing cards were working as gardeners. They were all busy painting the roses red.
Why must you do that?
Alice asked the three of clubs.
We planted white roses by mistake, and the queen will have our heads unless we change them all to red.
A trumpet blew, and the cards all scampered into line.
Make way for the Queen of Hearts,
called a familiar voice. Alice peeked around a car to see the White Rabbit leading the royal procession.
So this is why he was hurrying so.
Then Alice spotted the ill-tempered queen and her timid little husband. Behind them followed a file of stern-looking playing cards.
Who is this?
Snapped the queen, pointing to Alice.
Why, it's a little girl. Do you play croquet?
Alice curtsied.
Yes, your majesty, but I really mustn't stay. I'm trying to find my way home.
Your way?
Bellowed the queen.
All ways here are my ways. Off with her head!
The queen's cards rushed at Alice to carry out their orders.
Oh, fool! I'm not afraid of you. Why, you're nothing but a pack of cards.
Alice gave the cards a push, and they went flying in all directions. This made the queen very angry.
Off with her head!
She roared, and the cards regrouped for another charge. Suddenly, Alice woke up and found herself still under the shady tree.
Why, it was all a dream. Thank goodness. I've had quite enough of Wonderland for now.
I'm late for a very important date. No time to say hello, goodbye. I'm late. And when I wave, I lose the time I save. My fuzzy ears and whiskers took me too much time to shave. I run and then I hop. I wish that I could fly. There's danger if I dare to stop. And here's the reason why. You see, I'm overdue. I'm in a rabbit stew. Can't even say goodbye. Hello, I'm late.
Good morning, Mr. Chatterbox. I'd love to stop and chatter, but in 6 7/8 minutes, I must meet with the Mad Hatter.
The Mad Hatter. We must chat about a very important matter.
I'm off to see the Queen of Hearts, who lives up in the palace. And the very moment I'm through with her, I got a date with Alice.
I can't be late for Alice, or the Queen of Hearts who lives up in the palace. I'm late for a very important date. No time to say hello, goodbye. I'm late. And when I wave, I lose the time I save. My fuzzy ears and whiskers took me too much time to shave. I run and then I hop. I wish that I could fly. There's danger if I dare to stop, and here's the reason why. You see, I'm overdue. I'm in a rabbit stew. Can't even say goodbye. Hello, I'm late. Can't wait, I'm late for a very important date. I'm late. Can't wait, I'm late for a very important date. I'm late.